Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to our program, Communicate in Chinese. I'm your host, Mark Rowswell, otherwise known as Shan. Over the next 40 lessons, we'll be showing you the kind of language used in many everyday situations, like shopping or dining out. Maybe you've invited friends over to your house. Maybe you're asking directions or taking a bus, reserving a hotel. Maybe you've gone to a sporting event. What kind of language should you use in these situations?Well, we'll be showing you. We'll also be talking about the cultural and social background involved in these situations, so I'm sure you'll find the program not only entertaining, but also very useful. Each lesson is divided into three episodes that are broadcast through the week. After the end of every 9 lessons, we'll be having a major review to cover all of the material to date. Well, what's the first thing we should talk about? How about greetings? What are the kinds of things you should say when you meet someone for the very first time?The next few short dialogues should give us a good idea. Let's take a look.
早上好，刘经理。
哦，你好，小张。您好，刘经理。早上好，小李。
你好。
下午好，小江。最近忙吗？
忙，忙，太忙了。
是啊，我也太忙了，该考试了。
Now let's look at the dialogues line by line. In the first dialogue, Liu Ming is arriving at the office. One of the employees greets him by saying, 早上好，刘经理。早上好 ,good morning. 刘经理 ,now Liu would be his surname. 经理 is his title, manager. 刘经理 ,manager Liu.Notice for superiors or elders, it's more polite to address them using their full title rather than their name. Liu Ming responds,
你好，小张。你好 ,hello. 小张 means little Zhang.
So Zhang would be this person's surname. By calling him little Zhang, Liu Ming indicates that not only are they familiar, but Zhang is also in a junior position.
小张
早上好，刘经理。
哦，你好，小张。
The next employee says,
您好，刘经理。您好 is the polite form of 你好。
It also just means hello.
您好，刘经理。
Hello, manager Liu. Liu says,
早上好。Good morning. 早上好，小李。
Now this person's surname would be Li. 小李 is little Li.So again, Liu Ming is indicating that he's familiar with this person and the person is in a junior position.
早上好，小李。
您好，刘经理。早上好，小李。
In the afternoon, Xiao Jiang runs into a classmate at school. Xiao Jiang says,
你好。
Now we know that there are 4 tones in Chinese. For instance, 韩, first tone. 韩。Second tone, 喊, third tone, 喊, fourth tone. In this instance, 你 and 好 are both third tone. But when we have 2 third tones together, we change the first one to second tone. It sounds much better that way. So we don't say 你好, we say 你好. 你 changes into second tone. 你好。The classmate says,
下午好
Good afternoon.
下午好小江
最近忙吗 Have you been busy lately?
最近忙吗
你好
下午好小江最近忙吗
小江 says,
忙
busy. For emphasis, he adds,
忙忙太忙了
busy, busy, too busy. The classmate agrees.
是啊
You're right, or yes.
是啊我也太忙了
I'm also too busy.
该考试了
Now here, 该 indicates time. It's time for. So,
该考试了。It's time for tests. It's exam time. 该考试了。No wonder they're so busy.
忙，太忙了。
是啊，我也太忙了。该考试了。
再见。
再见。
Now let's talk a little bit about some of the cultural background with regard to greetings in China. Standard greetings in China are much the same as anywhere else in the world. Hello is simply 你好。您好is a more polite form. In English, we'd still say hello, but 您好is considered more polite and respectful. 你好吗is a question. How are you? How do you do? Or to be more polite, we could say 您好吗。欢迎欢迎。It's just a way of expressing welcome. Literally means welcome. 欢迎欢迎。Now, when people are more familiar with each other in China, when they meet, they might ask a rhetorical question. And perhaps some of the questions that they ask would seem strange to a foreign visitor or to a Westerner. For instance, someone might ask you, 上哪儿去? Where are you going? Well, they don't mean to interrogate you or anything, and you don't have to be specific when you answer. It's just a rhetorical question.You could say, 我出去走一走, I'm going out for a walk. Or, for instance, they might ask a question to which the answer is quite obvious, and they obviously know the answer already. For instance, if they've seen that you've just come home from work, they might ask, 下班了, are you just back from work? Or if they see in the morning that you've just got up, they might say, 起来了, are you just up?Of course, they know the answer already. The reason for asking a question like this is simply to break the ice and to start off a conversation. Now let's look at some of the vocabulary from the lesson. 忙 is another very commonly used word. It means busy. You'll see in our dialogues, it's often used when people first meet each other and are engaging in small talk.
最近忙吗?这几天特别忙。
好 simply translated means good, but it's very commonly used in many different ways in Chinese. For instance, it can be used as an adjective or as an adverb.
最近好吗?电影很好看。
Now that we've gone through the dialogues and looked at the vocabulary, it's time to look at some of the common expressions and sentence patterns used in greeting.
Good
morning, Liu Ming. Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning, Xiao Zhang.
你好。
你好。
您好，刘经理。
您好。
您好。
你好。
下午好，小江。
下午好。
下午好。
最近忙吗？
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 忙，太忙了。
太忙了。
太忙了。
你好。
你好。
您好。
您好。
早上好。
早上好。
下午好。
下午好。
最近忙吗？
最近忙吗？
不太忙。
不太忙。
很忙。
很忙。
太忙了。
太忙了。
早上好，刘经理。
哦，你好，小张。您好，刘经理。早上好，小李。
你好。
下午好，小江。最近忙吗？
忙，忙，太忙了。
是啊，我也太忙了，该考试了。
再见。
再见。
Okay, now let's do some substitution practice. Gai kao shi la. Gai followed by a verb followed by la indicates it's time to do something. In this case, the gai indicates it's time to do something. Gai kao shi la. It's exam time. It's time to take an exam. Let's see some substitutions.
考试了，
该吃饭了，
该开会了，
该起床了，
该上班了。
太忙了， too busy.太 means too much or excessive. Whatever you have too much of, you put between the 太 and the 了. 太忙了. I'm too busy. Let's try some substitutions.
太忙了.
太热了.
太冷了.
太棒了。
太酷了。
早上好，刘经理。
哦，你好，小张。您好，刘经理。早上好，小李。
你好。
下午好，小江。最近忙吗？
忙，忙，太忙了。
是啊，我也太忙了，该考试了。
Okay, that's it for today's lesson. We've been talking about greetings and some of the different greetings that you might use depending on different situations or different relationships between the people who are meeting. We hope you've enjoyed the show, and we hope that you'll come back next time. Today we learned how to say 你好, now it's time to learn how to say 再见. Goodbye. If you have any questions or comments about our show, please don't hesitate to write. You can reach us at CCTV9 English Channel.China Central Television, 11 Fuxing Road, Beijing, 100859, China.